Today on Amplified, we're going to dyno my Macintosh amp to see how many watts it's putting out. This episode of Amplified is brought to you by Dollar Shave Club. Go to dollarshaveclub.com/amplified, and you're going to see why everyone loves Dollar Shave Club so much. You're going to get great razors shipped right to your door, and you're going to save a ton of money at the same time. It's a no-brainer. Go get it. dollarshaveclub.com/amplified. I came in this morning to sit down and tinker with my amplifier. That's what I'm doing. And hot damn! Look what rolled right up. This is Steve Yeager's bagged Chevy. This thing's so hot, it's on fire on the side of it. It's got a flamed out paint job. Hot diggity damn! This truck is airbagged laying frame on the ground. F***ing up my driveway. And that's how we like it. We like the f***ed up driveways around here. If you got a smooth driveway, you're a bitch. Okay? I said it. Jordan's installing an iPad in the dash of this baby, which is gonna be the motherfucking cherry on top. So Steve's coming by to pick up one of our iPad side slider kits that are selling like hotcakes, so go get yours now before it's too late. Soundmanca.com.
It's a 2007 Silverado, custom built by Jake McKitty out there in Oklahoma City. Fat Fabs, full kicker system. They're looking to get a new iPad dash. Super pumped. I'll be sure to bring this sucker back. Very excited.
What do we got?
I recently received my SMD AMM1 from the FedEx guy, which I hate. FedEx can suck it. They park the truck and see when I leave, and they put a note on my door saying I missed my My AMM1. I had to wait 3 days. He probably opened it and rubbed it on his balls. I finally got it by leaving and sneaking and hiding behind a bush. The FedEx guy came up, I grabbed him by the legs, and I stole my shit out of his hands and signed for it. I stuffed his note up his ass. Sent him on his way. And to compensate for my inconvenience, I stole a box of cookies off his truck because there was a Nabisco box in there. Get the fuck out of here, FedEx man. This tool can tell you exactly how many watts your amp is putting out, as well as a million other things. But today we want to test the subwoofer channels in my amplifier because we want to see how much power is going to this 8-inch woof. With this amplifier, we're bridging channels 5 and 6 and utilizing them as one channel. I have my positive and negative wires hooked up to my amplifier, and I'm going to take the negative wire and pass it through the middle of the AMM1. Right through the fat hole in the middle! I stuck it in the hole! Now we're going to take the little probe pokers and we're going to stab the wires accordingly as we read the instruction manual. If you don't read the manual, f*** you. Okay, this isn't a video guide on how to use the shit if you don't feel like reading the manual. I'm just showing you what I'm doing. Okay, a lot of people are like, you didn't show me enough. Well, I'm not trying to f***ing give you a whole damn guide. I'm showing you what I'm doing. Do you let me in your house to show me your living room and then I ask to see your bedroom? Okay then, that's like if I go to shake your hand and you grab my balls. It's too much. It's beyond the comfort zone. Now Next, you crank the shit out of the volume knob until the clipping light comes on. The clipping light will tell you when you're distorting the shit out of your signal. Distorting your signal is exactly how you blow your woofer. So if you blew your sub and you're wondering how it happened, it's because you're dumb and you didn't adjust it correctly. You want to make sure your clipping light never turns on, and the way I made sure of that is by getting a Macintosh amp, because they don't clip. You turn the shit up all the way, they're good to go. That's what you get for $2,500, okay? If you want to use a $200 amp, you gotta turn your gains down. You're gonna drive a motherfucker crazy. So if one of you asks me why you blow your woofer, I'm gonna tell you the same thing, okay? First of all, I'm gonna tell you I don't give a shit. And next, I'm gonna tell you your amp is probably clipping to high hell. The gain is cranked all the way on my Macintosh amp. Channels 5 and 6 are bridged together straight to the 8-inch woofer. I was guessing we're getting 200 watts out of it, but we got a big fat 277. That's because the woofer is a 3-ohm woofer. In most cases, the lower the impedance of your subwoofer, the more power your amp is going to put out. But if you go too low, you're going to blow your amp out. You're going to pop a fuse, and then you're going to put your fuse in, and it's going to pop again because you broke your f***ing amp. Congratulations! This is a good result, and this is why I chose the 8-inch woofer, because we don't have a load of power here. We're not talking about 2,000 watts, people. This is 200 watts. We got 277 watts to work with. The woofer wants 250. We're in a good zone. I feel confident that we made all the right decisions so far to squeeze every bit of sound out of the equipment I have. I want the system to be well-rounded and efficient. Go to soundmanca.com and get one of our iPad kits for your car. It's the best head unit ever. Also get a Soundman t-shirt while you're there, support the show. And thanks Dollar Shave Club for sponsoring Amplified. We'll see you guys next time.